Hello everyone. In this video, you will learn how to include the Syncfusion chart control and configure the elements of a chart, such as the series, axes, legend, and title, in a Xamarin.Forms application. The Syncfusion chart library includes more than 30 charts ranging from basic charts to financial charts. In this tutorial, I am going to use bar charts to compare target versus sales data, as shown in the picture. I have already created a brand new Xamarin.Forms project in Visual Studio 2017 and added the model and view model classes to store the sales details. Sale info is the model class. It represents a data point in the chart. It contains three properties to store the year as well as the sale and target amounts. Sales view model is the view model where we declare a property called sales data, which stores the sale info objects. Now let's add the Sf Chart Nougat from nougat.org. Open the Nougat package manager of the solution, search for Sf Chart. This is the package that needs to be installed in all of the Xamarin.Forms projects, such as .NET Standard, Android, iOS, and UWP. I'm going to install it in all the projects, and this is the latest version when I'm recording this video. Make sure to read and accept the license before installing the package. The Sf Chart Nougat package is now installed in all of my Xamarin.Forms projects. Now let's configure the chart on the main page of the project. First, set the binding context to bind the data between the view model and the view. The view model in this case will be sales view model. Next, add the namespace of the Syncfusion chart on this page to access the Sf Chart classes. The Sf Chart class is available inside the Syncfusion.sfchart.xforms namespace. Next, create an instance of Sf Chart by using the alias name of the Sf Chart namespace we declared earlier. Now I am just making the Xamarin previewer visible to instantly see the output of my XAML page. Now we'll define the X and Y axes using the primary axes and secondary axes properties. There are five different types of axes available in Sf Chart to plot the data of various data types such as numerical, string, and date time. In this demo, the x-axis will show the years as a string, so we'll set the category axis to the primary axis property. The y-axis will show the amount, as it is a double value, so I am setting a numerical axis to the secondary axis property. Since the series is not added to the chart, the numerical axis is rendered with its default range of 0 to 1, and the category axis does not have any default labels. We can also switch the platform between Android and iOS and phone and tablet, and the same output will be rendered on all the platforms. Next, we need to add the series to visualize the data. As I'm going to compare the target and sale values, two column series need to be added to the chart to visualize those values. I'm adding the first column series and binding the data from the view model using the item source property. The X binding path and Y binding path properties are used to map the properties to fetch the values from the model object. The X binding path is year, and the Y binding path is target. These properties are declared in the model object, and now you can see the chart showing the target values in the previewer. The same output will be displayed in both Android and iOS platforms. Now we're going to add one more column series to visualize the values of sale. We'll be pulling the sale data from the same binding context as before, so X binding path is year again, and this time Y binding path should be sale for this series. Once we finish, the previewer will update and show both series side by side. To make this chart more meaningful, let's configure the title and legend to represent each series. We'll set an instance of chart title to the title property of SF chart, and the title will be target versus sale for this demo. And we'll be able to see this update in the previewer. Next, we'll enable the legend using the legend property of SF chart. You can see the empty legend icons are added with a different color to identify the series, but it does not contain any label to represent what the series is about. The label can be configured using the label property in each of the column series. I'm going to name the first series as target and the second series as sale. Now let's customize the axes by setting the title and format of the labels. I'm going to set the title as year for the primary axis using the title property of the category axis. I'll create an instance of the category axis.title and then set its text property to year. Once the changes are saved, the previewer will refresh and show the primary axis title. Now let's format the axis labels of the y-axis to show the dollar sign and represent the numbers in terms of millions. We can use the label style property to customize the axis labels. Set an instance of chart axis label style to the label style property of the numerical axis. And then we can use the label format property to customize the label with the dollar sign, a three-digit numerical value, and an uppercase M to represent millions. And that's all. Now we have configured the beautiful chart in a Xamarin.Forms application within a few minutes. Let's run this app in a real Android device and see what the output of the chart. I am running it on my phone and projecting it using Visor. And there we go. That's exactly what we configured and previewed in the Xamarin previewer. Now I'm going to run the same application in an iPhone simulator. But before running it in the iOS platform, an additional step is required in the iOS project to load the assemblies of the renderer projects. In the Solution Explorer, go to the iOS project and open the app-delegate.cs file. Inside the finish launching method, and after invoking the Xamarin.Forms init method, call the init method of sfchartrenderer. Then set the startup project as the iOS project. I've paired this Windows machine with my Mac using the Xamarin build agent so I can see the output of an iPhone within Windows itself. And as you can see, we have the same exact output on the iPhone as we did on Android without implementing any iOS specific code. Lastly, we'll deploy the UWP version of this app to make sure that we are getting the same output of the chart in that platform as well. For this, all we need to do is set the UWP project as the startup project and then just run it on the local machine. And once again, we get the same output in UWP without any additional platform-specific code. And that's it. So thank you for watching this video, thank you for your time, and we hope to catch you in the next one.